So we have Pastor Adu, the professor of virology, right? Virology at home.
Yeah.
And Daddy, what is your degree and what do you do?
I'm a consultant virologist.
Okay.
I'm a PhD in virology.
PhD in virology.
Professor of virology.
Okay, sir. So for this coronavirus, how does it work? Which type of virus is it?
Oh, very good question. We have two types of viruses.
Yes.
Either RNA viruses or DNA viruses.
Okay.
This particular coronavirus is an RNA virus.
Okay.
But they call it corona because the proteins surrounding it form like a crown.
Wow.
That's the crown, the Latin word for crown is corona.
Okay.
That's why it derived the name coronavirus.
That is wow.
Mm-hmm. So it's an envelope virus.
Okay.
It's an RNA envelope virus.
Okay.
So therefore more sensitive to environmental factors like disinfectant, heat. So that is why we have been advised to use all these things.
Okay, sir.
Disinfectant,
yeah.
Chloros, hypochlorite, alcohol to disinfect our hands. Because they cannot stay long.
On a human and
if they are disinfected.
Okay.
They are easily inactivated.
They
are easily inactivated.
Okay.
By chemical disinfectants.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So let's imagine someone did not kill the virus and the virus has gotten into the body.
Yes.
Where does it act on, like,
very good question. You know, viruses, they attach to where they have receptors.
Okay.
You see, attach to where they have receptors.
Yeah.
A virus that find itself in a place where it does not have a receptor cannot start infection.
Okay.
So the receptor for this particular virus, the receptor is in the respiratory tract.
Okay.
But more in the lungs. That's why the effect is more particular in the lungs. Now that's why you see people developing labored breathing. Now they can't breathe. Labored breathing, hard to breathe, because it start destroying the lungs, because that's why the receptors are.
Okay, sir.
That's what the receptors are. Some of the receptors are also in the upper respiratory. The lungs belong to the lower respiratory.
Okay.
And whereas our pharynx, the nose, the other part belong to the upper respiratory.
Okay, sir. Mm. So now let's imagine now it's in the lungs.
Mm.
Is there anything you can do to push it down so that, I think you said it's like acid, it doesn't like acid, that's why alcohol can kill it and all that.
That is why it says, if it is in your mouth already, if probably, you know, one of the things they are asking us not to do now, don't touch your mouth, don't touch your nose. But if the virus have to gain access through your mouth, through the oropharynx, through esophagus, so you can drink water to push it down to the stomach, where it's acid. It cannot survive in the acid medium.
Okay.
Because it is an envelope virus.
Okay. So things like drinking apple cider vinegar, which is acidic, would that help a little bit?
It can.
If we drink more water with apple cider vinegar, it can be able to at least push some of it down.
But that is when it's in not in the respiratory.
Okay.
You know, you can't drink water to go to all the
lungs. Yeah, that's true. That's true. Or maybe even inhaling, like using a diffuser with some apple cider vinegar might be able to help too, right?
Yeah, anything that we just look at, make it acidic.
Acidic.
Anything that we make it acidic, because they can't survive at pH 3 to pH 6, which is the acidic pH. They can't survive there.
Okay, thank you, sir, for your knowledge. We have, you're a CDC, you've worked with the CDC before, right?
Oh, yeah, from 1990 to 2009.
Awesome. Yeah, so I
was a visiting researcher, visiting virologist.
Wonderful. So we have Pastor Adu here, visiting researcher from CDC itself, United States CDC, telling us everything. Thank you for your knowledge.
Thank you.
And this video will be shared with permission so everyone can listen to. Okay, thank you.